COVID-19 has been a catalyst for a new world, provoking disorder and unrest and causing diplomatic relationships to quickly deteriorate.
One of the most challenging times we have known since the 1930s.
Post-depression and pre-war.
It feels like about 1937 to me, and in particular if you look at the behaviour of China annexing territories.
A blunt warning as the Australian government detailed a $270 billion military cash splash.
We are seeing profound shifts in the technology that is being developed and that is being militarised.
The lion's share will go to the maritime sector, a solid $75 billion. Air capabilities will be boosted by $65 billion, land $55 billion, and there's $7 billion for space, predominantly for more satellites.
It is important that we have much greater awareness of what is happening in space.
The big ticket item will cover the air and seas, a long-range anti-ship missile that will buy from the US Navy for $800 million. It has a range of more than 370 kilometres, but the government is looking into buying others that cover thousands.
It looks like the Pentagon came with a shopping list and Australia agreed to go out and pick up the tab.
The equipment and strategies aren't just to protect mainland Australia, but also our neighbours in the Indo-Pacific region.
Our new strategic settings will also make us a better, more efficient ally. It means a lot to us.
Territorial claims have seen tensions rise, with our Jindalee over-the-horizon radar network to now be expanded to cover the Pacific.
And that means for the first time since the Second World War, we have to be looking out east as well as north when we're considering where threats may come from.
And when. Tegan George for 10 News First.